No, get it now.
This might be one of the spiciest curries I think I've ever had in my life.
Oh yeah, it's like a barbecue sauce. Oh.
Hey everyone, I'm Steph, behind the camera's Chris, and we're hungry to travel. We are in Georgetown, Penang, and one thing the city is famous for is its hawker food. Cooked and prepared on the side of the road from a food cart, this is street food in its finest and purest form. So today we have a big day planned eating some amazing street food, but first we're gonna be trying the king of the fruits, durian. So come on, let's go. Durian is known as king of the fruits. Now, it's pretty expensive fruit, but it's also really interesting because you either love it or hate it. Some people say that it smells like garbage and has a really bitter taste, while other people say that it's actually quite sweet and creamy. Now, Malaysia is one of the top producers of durian in Southeast Asia, and you see these stands all over the place, and you can tell you're getting close to a durian cart because you can actually smell it from like a block away, which is why they're actually not allowed in hotels. So we're pretty excited. We're going to try some and see if we love it or hate it.
Abang, kumpul. Ya, abang.
Dia tu, siap. Naik. Naik
ni kira yang.
No.
Here we have our durian. Now you can tell it's an expensive fruit because the amount we got here was 25 ringgit, and we saw people buying whole ones that were about 200 ringgit, which is like $70
so expensive.
Canadian. So it's super expensive. So we just got this little guy who got a lot of eating ahead today, but
just wanted a little taste.
You know what? I find the smell of durian not horrible. It actually, I think it's a bit of a sweet smell. That's just me.
It's not too strong, but then again, people like my brother and some friends back at home, they hate it and can't stand it. But us, pretty good.
It smells pretty good. Got little gloves so you don't stink up your hands when you try it.
The variety of durian we got is coded 604, and it's a local variety here in Penang that grows locally here in Georgetown, Penang.
Look at that.
Such like a golden yellow color.
So soft too, kind of mushy feeling. Well,
cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. So creamy.
Super, super creamy.
You can see the seed is in there, right there. It's got quite a decently sized seed.
Yeah, I think each chunk kind of has a bit of a seed in it. Ooh, it's quite nice though. It's almost like the feeling of like tannins in your mouth is kind of what it gives me a little bit.
Yeah. Mm. It's actually quite sweet. It's not bitter. This version isn't bitter at all, because some durian versions are a little bit bitter, but it's quite sweet. Ooh. Creamy.
I really like this. This is really, really nice.
See that there. Honestly, almost like the consistency of an avocado.
Mm.
How like you, it kind of just kind of mushy in your mouth, but super tasty.
Yeah, very, very soft. It's kind of like almost like something between like an avocado and like a kiwi in terms of the like sourness to it. It's interesting. It's super interesting.
that is tasty. And there's actually hundreds of different types of durian in the world, so this is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to durian.
They're so squishy. Such a soft texture there. You can see your fingers just mush right into it. Look at that.
Honestly, this is tasty. And the smell, super mild, not strong at all, not very powerful. The taste, the flavor as well, not too powerful.
Not too powerful, but just enough. So we just got moved to another table to make room for a massive group coming in to get their durian fix.
People love their durian here. It's probably a group of like 20 people that took our spot. Look how nice and soft it is though.
Just smushes apart. Wow, this really is honestly such a true delicacy, such an exotic fruit that you can only get in some parts of the world. And honestly, it's like not even allowed in other parts of the world because of its strong smell. It's crazy. You can literally smell it from blocks away.
So exotic though, and so yummy.
So unique. It's very, very hard to describe because it tastes like so many flavors all at once, I find. Very, very different. This is super good. I really, really like this.
This is the perfect way to start our Penang food tour here at this durian hawker stall. Delicious.
Agreed. Jala, which is a very different type of roti. The way they make it, it almost looks like a doily. So we ordered it with chicken, and the pitcher on the menu at the front is like a little drumstick inside the curry, and this is like half a piece of chicken here. So this is massive. How cool this roti is. It's just like, it looks like it's shredded. The way they make it with the dough like that, actually really, really cool. It's got quite a springy consistency too. That's really nice. Just a hint of saltiness, nice and springy, a little chewy. I think it's gonna go great in this curry here. Look at that sauce, it looks so rich. That is a spicy curry, oh my goodness. With the roti jala all kind of shredded like that, it actually soaks up the curry sauce so much because of all the little holes it has. Look at that, really grabs all the curry sauce. This might be one of the spiciest curries I think I've ever had in my life. That is hot. This is a massive piece of chicken. Oh my gosh. Oh, look at all that white meat. Wow. So juicy. Look at that chicken there. That is a juicy, juicy piece of chicken. It's lovely and tender. It's not too dry or anything. Ooh, it's battered, kind of like a fried chicken. That's a nice little something extra to the top of it. Ooh, gives it a nice kind of fried flavor. This is really good. It's actually not as spicy with the chicken, with the curry sauce, than when you're just dipping the roti right in it. That's really, really good. That chicken's nice. good combo with the roti jala. That is good.
Hey, what are you doing over here?
Behind me is Fort Cornwallis, built in 1786. This makes Georgetown the first British settlement in Southeast Asia, so it just shows the long colonial past that Penang has. Have our bowl of koay teow ting. Now this is a popular Penang dish of Chinese origin, and we've got these lovely rice noodles, duck, possibly chicken, some green onions, fish balls it looks like. Just a massive bowl. Lovely, lovely ingredients here. And all in this nice, clear, light broth. Look at these lovely noodles. The noodles almost have a silky texture. They're so, so lovely and soft. Wow. And the broth is very, very light. Oh, look at a nice spoon of it. Ooh, that's lovely. Ooh, look at this nice, clear, delicate broth. Looks like there might be garlic chips or something like that in it as well. Ooh, that is lovely and garlicky. Ooh, wow, those garlic chips are really, really strong. That's nice. Look at that nice meaty piece of duck. Lovely and tender. Oh wow, it's got such a nice flavor with the broth. Even so, though it's so light and clear and delicate, it's got such a nice, quite strong flavor actually. Gonna get a try of these fish balls as well. That is a fishy fish ball. Even though it seems quite a more plain noodle, there's so many flavors going on with the ingredients that they have in here. Such a nice soup. I can see why it is a very popular Penang dish here. And they give you this nice little, looks kind of like a chili soy sauce on the side. So I'm just gonna give these noodles a little dunk, a little bath there, see what it's like. Ooh, that's a nice, salty, spicy addition. Ooh, that's quite nice actually. This is a delicious bowl of noodles. The noodles are honestly probably the best part. They're so silky and soft. They're amazing. With the hawker preparing, cooking, and serving the noodles here to all the tables of people lined up on the side of the road, this truly is authentic street food in Penang. Tastes so good. Those were some tasty noodles.
There's no better example of the hawker and street food culture here in Penang than visiting one of the night markets that they have here. So we are here at the McCollum Night Market. It's Monday night, so this night market only happens on Mondays. It's a long night market. They sell food, clothes, all the good stuff. So let's see what we can find to eat. So it looks like there's drinks, there's meat, there's fried food, there's soup even, so literally everything you can find. Satay. Our satay kebabs. We got three different satay sticks. We got two types of chicken and a pork one. Looks like we got like a curry chicken here. It's like a sweet curry chicken. That's tasty. Nice and tender. Cooked perfectly, really juicy as well. Like we got like a spicier red sauce chicken, maybe like a barbecue chicken. Oh yeah, it's like a barbecue sauce. Mmm, nice and juicy as well, and tangy. This one's good. I like the curry one better though. The one I've been looking forward to, the pork satay. You can see at the end there, got a little piece of pork fat there. This one looks nice and charred. Pork's always my favorite. That's tasty. So nice, the pork, juicy, sweet as well. Almost tastes like a pork jerky. Mmm, that is good. Get some of that fat there. Fat is nice and chewy. Of course, perfect. The meat. This is some good satay. Banana pancake?
Yeah, banana pancake.
Banana apple?
Yeah,
apple. Ah, okay, yeah. I think we're gonna have to get some. These look and smell so good.
Wow!
Like creamed corn.
Yeah, corn too.
Pandan. Oh wow. Pandan
coconut.
Oh. It's a brown sugar.
Oh wow.
Only I have.
Here we've got our little pack of appam, which are a type of pancake. So they do three different kinds. Corn, banana, and a pandan with brown sugar. So these are warm, fresh off the grill. looks so good. So they said that the batter is made with coconut as well, and obviously you can really smell it. The coconut scent is so strong. Oh, that's the banana. Ooh, banana's so nice and sweet. These are delicious. So good. Thank you very much. Oh, that banana one is so good. I don't know if you can see in there, but it's really nice and springy, the pancake. It's light, and there are chunks of shredded coconut in there. This is a nice treat. It's like we've got our little creamy corn in there. Oh, that's a nice sweet corn. Got a nice crunch to it. But again, honestly, these coconut pancakes are so tasty. Oh my gosh. Really looking forward to this last one, the pandan brown sugar coconut. Oh, look at that. Oh, you can really see the pancake here now.
Oh, nice and green.
Yeah, such a nice color to it. The brown sugar coconut. Ooh, that coconut in the middle, so nice. It kind of has like a toasted taste to it, actually. That's really, really tasty. The pandan flavor, very, very light. These are delicious. Thank you so much. Oh, those are delicious. Very good. Thank you.
The McCollum Night Market was pretty cool to see, but the food was a little night markety, so we wanted to end our day on a true hawker street here. So let's go see what we can find. Ooh, curry mee. We haven't had curry mee yet here in Penang.
With the prawn, cockle, at the feet, pork flat.
Oh, pork flat, huh?
We are ending our street food day off trying the Penang curry mee. Now, what makes Penang's curry mee special compared to other ones is that they include the pork's blood, pieces of the pork's blood, as well as they give you the chili sambal sauce separately on a spoon, so you can add as much or as little in as you want. I'm just gonna add a little bit in because we don't want to dilute the taste of the delicious curry broth, which is made with coconut milk. Oh, and you can see there, there's egg noodles as well as vermicelli, so you got the nice mixed noodles, as well as fish balls, some fried tofu balls there as well, bean sprouts. Oh, this looks delicious. And you can smell the nice coconut curry smell and flavor. That curry flavor, so coconut milky actually. That's really nice broth. It's very, very coconutty. Not spicy at all, even though we put a little bit of that sambal in. Ooh, try some of this pork's blood here. Nice squishy piece of pork's blood. Got that blood flavor. Perfect
with the coconut broth. Ooh, it's nice and creamy flavor as well, almost milky. The mixed noodles, I love how they mix the noodles because vermicelli, my favorite noodle, but having the chubbier egg noodle there as well, getting a bit of both, really adds to the texture and kind of the flavor of the dish. And the bean sprouts add such a nice crunch to the noodles. Bean sprouts are always the best with any kind of noodles. Add a little bit more of that chili sambal because it's actually not too spicy. Nice and milky and creamy though. The tofu and actually the pieces of the squid there as well. There's so many ingredients in this curry meat. So flavorful. Oh, look how creamy that curry broth is. A little bit red now with that chili sauce. It's so milky and creamy. Delicious. The cool and unique thing about the hawker stalls here in Malaysia is that each stall focuses on one specific dish and they're masters of that dish, so they make it to perfection. And you can really tell because everything we ate today has been so flavorful and delicious. Including this curry meat. Hope you enjoyed this video showcasing the amazing hawker and street food culture here in Penang. If you did, give the video a like, give it a thumbs up, hit the bell icon to get notified when we post a new video, and make sure you subscribe to our channel to join us on our next food adventure. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.